a problem from the book 1412. And it says that from historical data, Harry's car wash estimates that dirty cars arrive at the rate of 10 per hour. So that means with the crew working the wash line, Harry figures that cars can be cleaned at the rate of 1 every 5 minutes. So 1 every 5 minutes, the thing is lambda, if we are saying that this is in terms of per hour, so we have to convert service times also in terms of per hour. So if you have 1 every 5 minutes, so obviously in 1 hour you can clean 12. So this is 12. So assuming poison arrivals and exponential service time, so basically it says that this is model 1 and we need to find various things like average number of cars in the line, average time a car waits before it is washed, and so on. So we'll go to QM for Windows to do all those calculations and answer the question. So let me open that. So I'll just say okay. And automatically it lists under module all the different tools which are available and which are related to this book, and we are interested in waiting lines. So we'll click on waiting lines. Then we can say new, and it has different options 1, 2, 3, 4. So because we are dealing with a single channel situation, I'll say we use 1. So it opens up this window here, and you have like no cost situation and use cost situation. In this example, we don't have any cost, so we are fine with just going and clicking on OK. Arrival rate, you can see it says is, we can enter here 10, and service rate mu is 12. So please note that we have converted mu to 12. Book says 5 every 5 minutes 1, so that we have to convert to per hour before we can use this. And then you have number of servers, obviously that is 1, we cannot change that. And as soon as we do this, it has done all the calculations. So it tells us average service utilization is 0.83, 83%, that's very high. So server utilization means how often server is going to be busy. So 0.83 means 83% of the time the server is busy, only 17% of the time it is idle. Then you have average number in the queue, 4.17. So if you go back and look at the questions, the first question was average number of cars in line. So basically that is average number in the queue. So the answer is 4.17. Part B was average time a car waits before it is washed. Average time in queue here is 0.42. And please note that this is in hours. So in minutes it is 25 minutes. So they have to wait about 25 minutes before being washed. Average time, this is C, average time a car spends in the service system. So this one, average time in the queue, is different from average time in the system. Average time in the system means time spent in queue plus time spent getting the service, like getting the car wash. So obviously average time in the system which includes average time in the queue. So this is a bigger number. So you can see that about 30 minutes. So it is always going to be a bigger number. Part D is utilization rate of the car wash. So 83%, we have seen that. And then probability that no car are in the system. So you can also get an idea from server utilization. So 1 minus 0.83, you get 17%. So if you read the question, you will be able to find that lambda in this case is 12 per hour, mu is 15 per hour, and the difference now is that you also have cost figures. So service cost $10 per hour, waiting cost is $50. Now we can use this data and go to QM for Windows. So once again, I can click module and then waiting lines. So data has been modified, save file. I don't want to save it. So let me open first one. So now we can choose use cost and say okay. And you'll see that there are more options now. So lambda is 12. Mu is 15, and then you have number of servers. We don't want to change that because that is 1. So and now we can solve this problem. So part A is, what is the average time that catalog customers must wait before their calls are transferred to order clerk? So the average waiting time, in this case we are talking about waiting time in the queue, which is 0.27 or 16 minutes. B is, what is the average number of callers waiting to place an order? So that is basically average number in the queue, which is about 3.2. Similarly, you can also modify the information to answer C, which is, Ashley's is considering adding second clerk to take calls. The store would pay that person the same $10 per hour. Let's look at second model, because this model deals with only one server. So let me write down model 2 here, and then we can answer part C. So model 2 is M, capital M, capital M, and small case M. So we are dealing with M equals 2, and we want to find out what will be the savings if we can go for 2. So let's go back and see what was the total cost with one server. Now if you look at here, cost labor plus number waiting times waiting cost, which is 170. So we can make a small table. So total cost per hour, and this is with MM1 model, and then we compare with MM2 model. So with MM1 we have $170. Now let's go back and see what will be the cost if we have 2 instead of 1. So I'm going to edit data and see if we can do this. This will not allow because we used a single server. So we'll close this. And open a new file and select multi-channel system. We are also using cost, so we select cost and go there. So once again, lambda is 12, mu is 15, number of servers, now we are saying 2, server cost was 10, and waiting cost was 50. So if we click on solve, it will solve and give this answer. So the number we want to look at is this. Always when we are comparing, we should look at the cost labor plus waiting time and waiting cost. So 27.62. So 27.62 is the cost. So if you subtract, you get the savings. Savings equals. So this way we can compare and see what happens if we add one more server. Now let's look at model 3. So we are looking in this chapter at four models, and this is the third one. So this model is M, capital D and 1. Now when we use D, it means we are talking about constant service times, like coffee machine. So every time it is going to take that much time for one cup of coffee. And one once again means single channel. So for this, let's look at problem 27. So 27 says customers arrive at an automated coffee vending machine. So that example indicates constant service time at a rate of 4 per minute. So that's your lambda. And it also says following a Poisson distribution. So we are using a situation where arrivals are modeled by Poisson distribution. But please remember, arrivals could be something else also. So most of the times Poisson will work, but in many cases it could be something different. So we should use the model only when it is confirmed that the arrivals are Poisson. The coffee machine dispenses a cup of coffee in exactly 10 seconds. And then basically different performance criteria, like what is the average number of people waiting in line? What is the average number in the system? How long does average person wait in line before receiving service? So obviously all these questions can be answered very easily. So let me write down 14, chapter 14, problem 27. Our lambda is 4 per minute and mu is, so why 6? Because it says coffee machine dispenses a coffee every 10 seconds. So in 1 minute, you'll have 6 cups of coffee. So we have to keep the unit same. So if lambda is in minutes, mu should also be in minutes. Now let's open QM for Windows. So I will close this and will not save. And then file and new. So if you look at the second one, that's constant service time. So that's the one we want. In this problem, we have no cost. So we can say okay. And then lambda is 4. And service is 6. So we can click solve. Now, when you are using QM for Windows, one thing you'll notice that you have a column called value, and then there's a column called minutes, and then there's a column called seconds. So this will work very good if your original units are in hours. So it will convert hours into minutes and seconds. But in this problem 27, actually our units are already in minutes. So do not go by these two columns in that case, because this will be misleading. So this 10 here does not mean 10 minutes, or 600 does not mean 600 seconds. So we have to be careful. This will work only when your original units are in hours. So in this case, it is minutes. So you should ignore those two. So from this, you can see that again, average number in the queue is 0.67. Average service utilization is 67%, means that time, that amount of time it is busy, and remaining time it is basically idle or not in use. And average number in the system means Q plus the one in service. So there could be some people in the queue and then add the one who is in the service. So that's why this is always a bigger number. And same thing for time. So time in queue, average time in queue. So this is only queue. And in the system means Q plus service. So those people who are getting service, that is included there. So this number will be this number will be higher. That is model 3. Now the last model is model 4, finite source. So finite source is that limited calling population. So number of items or people are coming from a population which is limited. For this, let's look at 1429. So this is a manufacturing example. So one machine services 5 drilling machines for steel plate manufacturer. Machines break down on an average of once every 6 working days, and breakdowns tends to follow Poisson distribution, so which is capital M. The mechanic can handle an average of 1 repair job per day. So that is the service rate. Repairs follow exponential distribution. So that is again capital M, the second capital M in the model. So how many machines are waiting for service on an average? How many are in the system on average? So standard questions of any waiting line, basically to assess its performance. So let's look at lambda and mu. And note that there are only 5 machines. So this is finite population. And they can service 1 per day. So with this, we can go to PUM for Windows. Let me close this. Do not save and open new. So now I'm going to use the fourth one, which is limited population model. And again, no cost in this example. Average rate per customer. So 1 divided by 6 is 0.17. Mu is 1. And population size is 5. So with this, we can click on solve. So using this, we can easily answer the questions like how many machines are waiting for service on an average. So this is average number in the queue. So 0.54. B is how many are in the system. So in the system, average number in the system is 1.19. So more than one machine in the system at any point of time. What is the average waiting time in queue? So average waiting time in queue, you can see, is 0.83. And this is days, so 0.83 days. And again, this 50.1 and this other numbers doesn't matter because this is in days. So obviously from days, this calculation in minutes and seconds is not correct because these calculations are based on general units in hours. So we should ignore minutes and seconds column. Part E is what is the average wait in the system? So you can see that average wait in the system is 1.83 days. The situations which are given in these four models may not always be true. Like you could have a situation which is very different from what is given in the models, and it can make things very, very complex. When you have a very complex situation which is difficult to model using waiting lines, so one way to deal with this, with that situation, is to go for what is called as simulation. So we simulate the conditions and then see the performance. So simulation is the topic of our next chapter. So